Welcome in Babita Science Tutorial. Let's continue our chapter Chemical Reactions and Equation of a Class 10th NCERT Science Chapter 1, and this is a Part 11 of a Chapter 1. In the previous videos, I have completed all these things, and let's continue new topic or new video of this chapter. That is a chemical reactions and equation. In this video, I will explain you about the corrosion. Student, what's the meaning of the corrosion first? Corrosion means junk lagna. Okay. Then corrosion is the process in which metals are eaten up gradually by the action of a air, moisture or a chemical such as acid on their surface. That is called the corrosions. And now you will see the topic here. Have you observed the effects of oxidation reactions in everyday life? Yes, we have observed. No, that there are the two common effects of a oxidation reactions which we observe in daily life are, first one is a corrosion and second one is a rancidity. Let's start the topic. This one, corrosion, I have given already the definition of the corrosion. And see here, in this paragraph, you must have observed iron articles are shining. Yes, when iron articles are shining in the new time, okay, but slowly this iron substances is coated with the reddish brown powder, okay, when left for the some time. The dead process is called the rusting of a iron. Okay, means iron means junk lag jana, that is called the rusting of a iron. And rusting of iron needs a air, moisture, okay, and humidity. Due to the presence of these three things, we can say that rusting of iron can take place. And some other metals also tarnished in this way, lose the shining in this manners. Okay, then you will see here, have you noticed the color of the coating formed on a copper and silver? When the metal is attracted by a substance around it such as a moisture, acid, etc., it is said to corrode, and this process is called the corrosion. I already given the definition of the corrosion. Corrosion means it's the process in which metals are eaten up slowly by the actions of air, moisture or chemicals on the surface. That is called the corrosion. And the rusting of an iron metal is the common name form of a corrosion. Okay, then see here, the black coating, the black coating on a silver and the green coating on the copper are two examples of a corrosion. Students, here two examples are given about the corrosion. First one is the black coating on a silver. Silver means chandi. Okay, black coating is occur on the silver utensils or silver ornaments, and the green coating on of copper. Green coating or copper are the other examples of the corrosion. So here two examples are given about the corrosion. Now see here, the side effects of the corrosion here. What is the side effect of the corrosion? Corrosion cause damage to the car bodies, bridges, iron railings, ship, and all objects made of a metals. No, so you can see that here corrosion is not good for the metals, because corrosion can destroy the metals. No, like car bodies, bridges, and only how the corrosion takes place, due to the presence of a air, water vapors or humidity. Okay, and this one, an acid can cause the corrosion. Okay, then especially those of a iron. Corrosion of a iron is a serious problem every year. An enormous amount of a money. Yes, enormous means big amount of, heavy amount of money is spent to replace the damaged iron. So this is all about the corrosion, students. Corrosion is nothing. It's a rusting of the iron, and the rusting of iron takes place with the help of the air, moistures and acids also. And we can see that the rusting of iron is a redox reaction because it's an example of the oxidation reaction. The oxidation reactions in which gaining of oxygens and removal of a hydrogen, then in the corrosion is the example of the oxidation reactions. Now another is I hope students you will understand this paragraph, what is a corrosion. Okay, in the junior section you have studied about the corrosion, how to prevent the metals from the corrosion. Many thing is given in the junior classes, and you know better, many preventions is given here, but not in the book it's a given, but in the junior section it's a given how to prevent the metal from the corrosions, like painting, galvanizations, oiling, greasing, many thing more. Okay, in this way you can protect the metal from the corrosions. Let's move on the rancidity. Rancidity means rainy seasons, and if you keep the food for a long time, a bad smells is a comes out from the fats and oil, or we can say that bad unpleasant smells and taste is a comes out from the fats and oil. Okay, then we can say that the oxidation also damaging effect on foods containing fats and oil. Okay, now here in the next paragraph, when fats and oils are oxidized students means what here? Oxidized means gaining of oxygen. Okay, gaining of oxygen, it means when the oxygen comes in the fats and oils, they become a rancid and their smell and taste change. Okay, unpleasant smell will comes out when the fats and oils are oxidized. Okay, then we can which type of definition we will give here? Rancidity, we can say that the condition produced by aerial oxidation of fats and oils in food marked by unpleasant smell and taste is called the rancidity. Okay students, now see here, UV substances will prevent oxidation. Antioxidants are added to food containing fats and oils. Okay students, here some precaution is also given here, how you will prevent your fats and oil from the rancidity. Then first one here, it is given that you can use the antioxidants. Okay, the antioxidants means what? Antioxidants are usually reducing agent, and reducing agent means which can remove the oxygens and adding the hydrogen, that is called the antioxidants. Means here precaution is given. In your book only one precaution is given, and another book, sorry, here two precautions are given here. Keeping food in a airtight containers helps to slow down oxidations. First precaution is using the antioxidants. Okay, and the second precaution is keeping food in airtight containers helps to slow down oxidation. Then students, these two are given, these two prevention is given here, but actually many prevention is given not in this book. Okay, but you can use it, how to prevent your fats and oils from rancidity. Okay, first one is antioxidants. Okay, and another one is keep the food in the airtight containers, and another thing also you can prevent the food from rancidity if we keep the food in a refrigerator also. Okay, and you know chips packets and this one also, then these are prevented by keeping in the nitrogen gas. Okay, then the nitrogen gas cannot be cause the rancidity. Okay, so see here, do you know that the chips manufacturers usually flush bags of a chips with gas such as nitrogen? Which gas is it? Nitrogen, to prevent the chips from getting oxidized. The students, we can see that in this paragraph actually they have given some precautions, or they have given some retarded slow down the rancidity. Okay, then first one is by using the antioxidants. Second one is using the airtight containers, and third one is keep in the refrigerators, and fourth point is rancidity can be prevented by packaging fats and oil containing foods in nitrogen gas. So in this way you can prevent your food, or we can say you can prevent the fats and oils from the rancidity. Then this is only this much in this paragraph in rancidity, and we have completed this chapter, chemical reactions and equations. Then first chapter is completed here, and here students, some question answers are given here. You can try this question answers. If you understand this chapter, I hope you will do this question answers. You will not facing any kind of the problem. Okay, if you have any problem, then comment me in my comment box. Till then, bye and have a nice day.